What's up, everyone? Mike back here for what's probably going to be the finale of Alan Wake 2. Return 9. Come home. Oh boy. Well past the point of no return here. We just broke Saga out of the mine. The cursed mine place. Where she hates herself. You would think by now I would know the geography of this area a little better. Just get right to that. Let's see who's there.
Hello?
Is that her talking?
The ending? A shoebox? Who is this?
Was that her or Alice's voice? Maybe Alice. It looked like we had to use the picture. Alice caught the clicker. I don't really think she killed herself. Breaker? I missed him in that last Alan Wake section. I couldn't get into that room.
Agent
I couldn't
Anderson.
figure it out. It's probably a different thing.
Is that really you? Sorry, this place likes to play tricks.
Sheriff Breaker?
What are you doing here?
What happened to you? How did you end up in the dark place?
I was brought here. Snatched away from the morgue by a man named Worland Dorr. Been trying to piece it together for... Well, it feels like a long time now.
Who is this Dorr person?
He's here. Somewhere. I've been seeing his face in my dreams for years.
Interesting.
This whole thing is insane. But he is much more than he seems. He's connected to all of this.
Ooh, I can profile him.
I need to get to Parliament Tower Plaza. Do you have any idea where it is?
This place, it's like trying to find your way around in a dream. I've been trying to map it, but it keeps looping and shifting. Like there are many versions stacked on top of each other. There is a page. Describes Dorr finding his way through this place. I tried to follow the steps, but no luck.
Can I see it?
Can I see that page, Tim?
Of course. In fact, it's the page I tried to give you back in the morgue in Bright Falls. Huh. Now that I think about it, maybe Dorr brought me here to keep you from reading it. Here.
You sure you want to do that?
I'm gonna keep looking for Dorr. The closer I get, the closer I feel to waking up. I need to find the man behind the curtain.
Worland Dorr walked across the rain-slick tiles of Caldera Street Plaza. He stopped at the door to the construction yard. A poster for his talk show hung there. He stepped through, willing it to take him to Parliament Tower Plaza.
I know what I need to do. The door to Parliament Tower Plaza was at the construction yard.
Okay. Like I know where that is. Where am I? This isn't going to show me anything. Oh, boy. I wonder if we're safe in here now. You would think so, but who knows? Door? I don't know if this is gonna work. I feel like he's a very strong extra-dimensional entity.
This is the first time I've seen a page about Warlindor. Who is he?
A door that stands between two rooms is in both. A door that can lead anywhere is everywhere. That door is the center. He governs the currents of reality.
With all the powers mixed up in this, it's hard to know who's playing who. Opening too many doors. This isn't important right now. I can look into it later.
Ooh, that's the most inconclusive deduction she ever came up with of these profiles. But
the page describes him moving through the door. How can I do that?
The dark place has many faces and many names. It is a mirror, reflecting all possible realities.
Huh.
The family of Doors have the power to shift between these realities. Here and elsewhere.
If I can find a way to navigate through this nightmare, maybe I can find a way to get back home.
Okay. Do I have anything new to do here? Other than all the collectibles I didn't get. Alright, let's get out of here. How do I get anywhere? And I don't have a map of this area, do I? No. Once again, there. In this endgame, throwing me in a situation where I don't have a map, and I'm not good at navigating this game. Let's see, what are these? I'm not done fighting stuff, I don't think. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late as destination. A lighthouse. Well, that's from the beginning of the first game. So is this, I think. The departure. It's the end. It's not a lake, it's an ocean. Oh, this is the door to the construction yard? Well, that's convenient. This game will try to scare me still, I'm sure. Oh boy. Yeah. It's not like your stories are any good. Not like they have any artistic merit. You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and pretentious shit. That's all you're good for. Just look at me. Look at your work. Good God, little. Is that meta too? I would like to interview, like, Sam Lake and see, like, that's where I came from.
I made it. I need to get up to the street and find that statue.
Oh, this is the right way to go. I'm so stupid. Wonder if Sam Lake and the other writers of this game end up spooking themselves with it a little bit. So meta. Art house classics are forever. This isn't the right statue. I'm humming again. Are we sure I didn't go the wrong way? I'm confused again. Let's go back in there. I think I did this wrong. See if there's anything else, since I'm slightly regretting all of the stuff I did not pick up or search for earlier. No, I don't see anything. Interesting. Good. Bad that I'm picking them up. Not done fighting. Definitely not done fighting. Don't have a lot of stuff, though. Oh my. To be fair, let me quick map these. This is what I keep forgetting. I don't even have the block it? That's bullshit. Okay. This is my only health. Do it there. I never figured out how to use those tanks. To shoot them on the ground, or would they blow? It didn't look like they would blow up if I threw them, and I just lost track of them if I threw them on the ground. In any event, oh, it's supposed to be
enough already.
Shadows. They're not gonna say wake. That guy looks solid. I don't think they're gonna do anything to me if I trigger this first.
The clicker, and some kind of bullet, shining with light. How did the clicker get here from Washington?
How did you get here from Washington? Oh boy. Oh, Jesus, okay. Did I not have my health up at all? What happened there? Oh, for fuck's sake. It then a little more. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. What? Do I have my quick equip stuff? I just have a lot of batteries, I guess.
Enough already.
I don't know what there's.
There's the shoebox. The clicker. And some kind of bullet. Shining with light. How did the clicker get here from Russia?
God, it's taking forever to kill these guys.
Yes?
Hello. You don't know me, but you need to listen.
More voices.
How did you know the clicker would be there?
This is important. Alan's lost. He doesn't have the ending. He needs your help to finish the story.
How am I supposed to help him from here? Okay. I'm in the dark place. Wake is in Washington. I could talk to him in overlaps before. My mind place is more powerful than I ever knew. I can try to contact him.
From the mind place. Maybe we should go to the light before I go to the mind place. Just a thought.
My only way to contact Wake is through the mine place.
Right. Well, these guys don't move too much, but I'd still rather be safe than sorry. This is where Breaker was. Are you coming for me? Just a lantern. Okay.
In my mine place, I can do things I never thought possible. Maybe I can reach Wake.
These guys are coming. Were they all just for show? That was kind of a waste, wasn't it? I should be safe here, in theory. Okay. It was 6 last time. I don't think I pet another deer. Can't do this. Alright, I guess we're profiling Wake again. We need to talk.
Alan, we need to talk about the ending.
Saga, what is this?
My mind plays. I've reached out to you like this before. But I understand more about it now.
You see visions too. I used to think they were ideas, inspiration, but they're real. Just like this now. I try to use them to make the story come true.
So this is coming from both of us. Maybe that's how we could communicate in the overlaps. We could use this to stop Scratch.
First, I need the ending.
Is there a problem?
So there's a problem with the ending?
I don't have the ending. It has to be perfect, but I don't have time to figure it out. I don't know what to do. Fuck. I'm so sorry. This whole thing is a fucking mess.
I agree. But we can still figure this out. And what exactly does perfect mean?
The elements of the ending need to come from the story's pre-existing parts. To make matters worse, this is a horror story.
I guess I'll have to go in the order he said that.
So the ending has to be earned, set up by the story. You can't build a case without supporting evidence.
That's the only way to make it stick.
This is cool.
You don't need to tell me this is a horror story.
Right. The ending has to fit the genre if it's going to work. In a horror story, there are only victims and monsters.
There must be a way to bring a hero into the story.
If there is a hero, they will ultimately pay a heavy price.
I can't let the horror story take Logan and Casey. They were dragged into this. They need to survive. Non-negotiable.
Not just them. We need to try to save everyone. I have an idea how to help Casey. He's a real person who I twisted into a character. He isn't my creation, so he isn't a suitable host for the Dark Presence. I can write that into the ending to drive that fucking thing out of him.
Okay. I guess we go here.
Well, if the ending has to fit the story, this is how I see it. Return is a story about a story that comes true. And I'm a character in the story.
Not just a character. The hero.
Okay, a hero. In any case, I've been through hell to be here. And this is my life. It feels earned to me that I rise above the story and be there to create the ending.
Yes. That's what we're doing. Here, now. We're figuring out the ending I need to write.
Interesting. This is not your ending?
This isn't Scratch's ending. But this isn't your ending either. This is our ending. You aren't the only one deciding these things anymore.
You're right.
It's probably for the best.
Every time I write, things only get worse.
You beat this thing back in 2010, Alan. And here you are doing the same again. You're a hero, too. We're in this together.
Then let's bring it home.
All right, so what is the price? Are they both gonna get stuck in the dark place again? Are they gonna die? Is one of them gonna die?
The ending will have to be dark, no matter what. The more people we save, the greater the cost. And the hero must pay the price.
One of the heroes. The scales always need to balance. Fuck it. Let's go with this.
Are you sure?
There's no time for anything better. Scratch could be here any second.
Then that's our ending.
Oh boy.
I have the clicker. I'll find a way to get it to you.
And I'll get the pages down. See you on the other side.
We're not talking about what we're doing here. Enter the fountain.
I need to retrace my steps back to Caldera Street Plaza. I arrived in the dark place through the fountain. Maybe I can leave that way too.
The golden bullet's gonna be for probably Alan. What have we got in here?
The ending we talked about.
I have the clicker and the bullet of light. Let's do this. I have to be the one to do it.
I feel like I've always been on this journey. Okay. It must end here, this darkness. What lies under the surface now shifts. A play of shadows catching my eye, thrusting my face into the water.
He's here.
It's shockingly cold, past the mirror of the surface. And I will see.
You see?
Before burned away by this terrible realization. Maybe it's a mercy, forgetting.
to know nothing when we loop around, back to...
Times is he gonna get shot in that chair? You're calling from the dark place? Is this gonna work?
Anderson.
Speeding up these credits, hopefully. I always am skeptical of skipping these with games. That you're gonna miss something. Awesome. Oh.
This part is just for you. After the haunting started, I got in touch with an organization that was still looking into what happened in Bright Falls. I went to their offices and...
Ooh.
Something happened there. After I got home, I could suddenly remember everything. I remembered being trapped inside that lake. A dark ocean with echoes of myself. My fears, my photos, inside a dark tide of madness, the same events and images looping again and again. And then I saw a light. Your light. You dove in just as I swam out. You never drowned. And you're still there, reaching out. That is what the haunting is. I can see you because I've been there too. I chose to come back to the dark place. That is why I put on this exhibition.
Oh.
I had to mislead you, so that I could get you to where you needed to be. The only way out of your loop is destruction or ascension, light or dark. And we've covered the destruction part many times over. And we're getting to the ascension bit by bit. Time means nothing here. You'll still need to go through the loop. But I will keep showing you the images you need to see. The light you need to see. Until you're ready. Alan, I think we're getting close.
Oh. Did he just heal his head?
It's a spiral.
Everyone said that on Reddit. Is this... It's not a lake, it's the ocean of this game? Now, what does that mean? A loop means, you know, you're doing the same thing over and over. Spiral means you're going further and further into the depths or middle of something. Although, in the end, you kind of go nowhere.
To lift me up to new heights. Sensation compelling. And I'm closer to the edge. Temptation.
Well, we're rolling credits here. Wondering if this there'll be any post-credits thing. I would like an answer for Saga's situation more than a phone call that's never answered. So what do we have answered here? Let me see. Obviously, this was a shorter one. I knew I was near the end, but it was very late last night, the last part. As you can see, if you're following me, it was nearly 5 hours long because I got caught up in it. So here we are with like a, I don't know, 45 minute one here. We'll see. Lots of thanks here. Also, on my way home from work to come play this, I listened to the old Gods of Asgard song, Herald of Darkness. The part which, unfortunately, in this playthrough we missed. Just look it up on YouTube. It was very fun. It was a good sort of break in the horror. Musical section that took place in that late night show thing. Lance Reddick. I wonder if Lance Reddick was supposed to be Mr. Norr first. Guess this guy seems very similar to him. No shade at this actor, I don't know his name, but he was good too. Nothing. They didn't give me anything. Oh boy. Can I change stuff either? Why is that a thing? What happens if I press continue? Or will I just be at the last save? That was it then. That was Alan Wake 2. Both Alan Wake 1 and Control had some pretty decent DLC. So I would be very curious to see what would happen there. And I know people are waiting on New Game Plus. That I don't know if I would play through the whole game again, but I do. I did miss a lot of stuff to collect. I'm sure no one wants to see me do that. I'm not sure I even want to do that. Overall, I really liked it. I'm glad I played it. I had a little bit of trouble with just the genre, the survival horror thing, the sort of intentional clunkiness of the inventory management. You see how long it took me to do some of more of those more action-heavy parts? You'd get what I mean. It's... Especially, like, some of this game actually seemed like it was designed for mouse and keyboard before a controller. I'm playing this on a PlayStation 5, obviously. Because, you know, when you go to the map, my cursor's just way to the side, zoomed in a weird way. The case board was hard to navigate as well. But overall, no. Those are my issues, but I really liked it. I think I liked the saga sections a little more than Alan. It's a little more straightforward. Scary in a different way, like I mentioned earlier. Just waiting on those jump scares and going through some pretty scary parts. Alan's sections were not as fun for me, mostly, until we got to the the We Sing part on the in there. That was the one action part, and again, I'm sorry you didn't see me play it, actually. Because I lost those 2 hours. There was one action park I liked because it was better at giving you, like, just re-upping your ammo for the stuff you already had equipped in that area, so you can, while the music was playing, blow away a bunch of enemies. I really had a tough time with some of that late game stuff with Saga on that beach there at Cauldron Lake. It's just not managing to pick up the right items with the way I was looking at them, and even in the supply box, and just whatever. But no, good game. Lots to think about. And Honestly, I'm ready to dive into the Reddit discourse, sort of breaking down some of these questions and answers. So, for what I gather here, we don't have a real Tom Zane answer in this. Now, Wake claims Tom Zane is, the writer that I still think that Wake wrote into existence. Maybe he didn't. That's just my own theory in the first game. Because he came out of nowhere to sort of be the helper, the someone, the person who basically did the same thing he did at Bright Falls earlier. But he did not, he wasn't really mentioned until Alan needed help, it felt like to me. But I don't know, people consider him sort of a reincarnation of him. Obviously, Thor and Odin call him Tom all the time, Alan, so I don't know. And then Wake here said very deliberately that Alex Casey was not a creation. It was a person that got turned into a character from a little bit, which is more confusing to me a little bit. And we don't know if it was Alan or Scratch who wrote Logan into the story. We don't know if this worked at all, honestly, other than Alan somehow seeing Alice's message after the light shot his head. Lots to think about, but, the themes are there. Very metagame. I'd like to ask Sam Lake and whoever else wrote this, a few questions, for sure. But that's it. This is probably going to be the end of the playthrough. I don't particularly think people are going to want to see me do non-story stuff, struggling to try to find any stuff on the side. So, there I did. I made it. I survived a full-fledged horror game. Pretty scary, but I'm an adult. Even playing at night in my basement in low-light headphones. Thank you guys if you've been following this, and I don't know, let us know on All You Can Geek. You can talk here or in YouTube comments or anywhere if you want to see any other playthroughs. I don't have a camera myself. The other guys might see what they want to play, but yeah, let us know. It's not too hard to broadcast here, so that'll be it for me. Yeah, only 43 minutes, and the last few were just me talking, this last bit. But that's the finale for you. Sometimes it's short. I'm very curious what DLC they might have for this, though. Because you would have to answer the Logan question, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? We'll see. Alright. See you guys later. See you on the other side.